Welcome everyone, and thank you for joining me for a demo of Hedge, risk management app for Jira Cloud. Hedge integrates with your existing Jira project data to give you and anyone on your team the ability to create risk registers, conduct risk assessment, prioritize and report with a clean, intuitive, and super easy to use interface. So let's have a look at demo. First things first, after you install the app from the Atlassian marketplace, you will be able to find it under apps and then Hedge. The first screen that you will be able to see is this risk register screen, where you can find all your created risk registers. You can notice that the risk register has a name, it has also selected projects, it has an owner, so you know who is responsible for the risks, and it also has a status, which is active or archive. So you can also archive your risk registers once you stop using them. In this column, you can see that you can select multiple projects for your risk register, so you can do a cross-project risk management as well with Hedge. To create a new risk register, you just click here on this Create Risk Register button, and here you can give your new risk register a name, you can select the owner, and then projects where you would like this risk register to be effective in. And then you also need to select the issue types. So what kind of issues you would like to manage in this risk register. By default, there is a risk selected as an issue type, but you can also select additional ones, like for example, stories or tasks and so on. And the last but not least, you also need to select the risk management template. Now, the risk management template usually differ with the size of the matrix and what kind of metrics you are assessing, but also the risk level setup, and if you're also managing inherent and residual risk or only the risk in general. So you can select one of the templates that fits your needs and then create a risk register. Once you create your risk register, you will land on this risk register screen. Now here you will be able to see all the issues from that issue type that you selected during the creation. If you don't have any issues in this list, you can create a new risk from this view and you can quickly add it into your list as well. Here on the top, you can see a filter, so you can filter your table easily by a project, status, assignee, or a creator, but there are also more filters available if you need, like for example, label, status category, component, or issue type. In this view, you can see all the issues that are in this risk register. You can see their summary and the issue key, but you can also open the issue in this screen to see more details about it or to maybe change some information, like for example, assignee if you want to assign this risk to someone else. Here, then you can see some additional columns with the additional information, like when the risk was created, so you know how old or how new the risk is, and you can also order your table by these. You can see who created the risk and who is assigned to this risk. On this side over here, you can see the risk levels and the risk score and factors or the metrics that are contributing to this risk score. So here you can select the values for your risk metrics. So for example, risk probability is unlikely and risk impact is moderate for this particular risk. And then you can see the risk score is automatically calculated together with the risk level. In this case, I am assigning inherent and residual risk here, so if I want to assign residual risk, I can do it on this side over here. And the same thing, the residual risk score will be automatically calculated together with the risk level. Now, if I want to change anything on this template or you want to customize your risk matrix, you can go to risk settings. And here you can change the risk framework name, you can also delete it. There is a risk score section where you can edit your risk score formula if you need. And on the bottom here, you can edit your metrics, so you can change the color of these metrics, you can change the values as well, which influences the formula, and you can also change these labels or add additional values here. And on the bottom here, you can see the risk matrix where you can create the new risk levels and you can also change the risk matrix setup over here. There is also general settings section available where you can change the risk register name, you can also change the owner, or you can add additional projects where this risk register should be effective, and you can also change the issue types. So once you assign the scores to your risk register, you can order your backlog of risks by the priority score from the highest to lowest to see the most important risks on the top. But there is also this report section, which you can quickly access, and it will show you the reports based on the metrics and risk score that you assessed. So here you can see there are two different reports, one for inherent risk and one for residual risk. So for inherent risk, you have this risk matrix over here where you can see the distribution of your risks. You also have a risk levels distribution in this section in the simple pie chart. So you know, for example, that you have a lot of moderate and low risks and you don't have as many extreme risks. Here in this section, you can see the distribution of the risks per status. And here you can see the risks raised over time. And the same comes for the residual risk as well. So you get the risk matrix, risk level distribution, the risks per status, and risks over time as well. In terms of the application security and data storage, we completed security self-assessment program and you can learn more about it in our marketplace listing. Hedge also doesn't store any personal information and it also doesn't store any information on our servers. The app is built on the latest Atlassian framework Forge and all data are stored and processed on the Atlassian side. We also have a 24-hour SLA policy on our support, but we usually reply in less than 4 hours. In terms of pricing, Hedge is a Jira app paid via Atlassian. It comes with at least 30 days free trial and after that you will be billed for the app together with your Atlassian tools bill. Depending on how you pay for your Jira, you would also pay for Hedge, either monthly or yearly. And the app is paid for all users in your Jira. So to make sure that the bill isn't as high, the more users you have, the price per seat decreases. The app is also free for up to 10 users, so if you're a small company or you want to test the app in your own test environment, you can use it for as long as you need for free. And that's about it. I hope that you enjoyed this demo of Hedge, risk management app for Jira Cloud. If you do have any questions, you can always reach out to our support or check out our documentation on wiki.jaxa.io. Have a great day!